Welcome back to the Ghost Key. I am Gray, and today we are going to remove egg sacs from giant ass mosquitoes. Quite literally, that is what we're going to do. Don't ask me why this is pertinent to, you know, the safety of the world or whatever the fuck, but it is. So we've got to go kill some giant ass mosquitoes and remove their egg sacs. Okay, I hope you're prepared to do this. Because I am. And let me see, big ass mosquitoes. Really gross things. But anyhow, I did take a look at the Conjurer a little bit, some of the class stuff. We are going to be, we won't be able to do anything until, add any cross classes, or I should say we can add some cross classes, but we won't be able to add any that are going to be that great for us. In other words, I mean, we're not going to be able to add anything that we'll be able to use cross class wise when we transfer over or turn into a white mage or what have you. So the only thing that will kind of transfer with you into the white mage thing is the Arcanist, which is the other class you have to have to be a white mage. So that obviously will be our main priority. However, we have to get to Limsa Lominsa to do so, which is another, I guess, continent main city is what I'm gonna call it. It's not really, I don't think it's on a different continent, but anyway, it's on another, it's in one of the other main cities. And in order to get there, we have to basically get to level 15 and go through the storyline and do that quest. So that's what we'll be doing at some point. So basically what that means is we're going to be stuck with these two offensive spells until level 15. Kind of boring, because that's what I was looking for. I was looking for something else to kind of spice it up, give us a little something, a little more firepower, because it's going to be pretty boring to watch me just hammer two spells the whole fucking time. But like, to me, I mean, it's really, I don't think any other, I don't think we get anything offensive out of any of the classes that we can cross-train here in Gridania. So, that is what it is. Sorry about that. But I'm admittingly having fun just rolling with the Conjurer. I mean, I usually like weird shit like the, you're level 9. Why are you level 9? Why are you so much, because you're part of the, no? Yeah, I think you are. I think you're part of that little thing that that person's doing over there, the whatever you want to call it, the levy. But anyhow, like I said, it's going to be kind of slow going for a while in terms of killing shit, because I was really hoping to get some more DOTs and shit, because I'm a big fan of dots and whatnot, and that's one thing I kind of wish this game had a little bit more of. I don't think this game has enough DOT spammers, well, fucking whatever you want to call it. You're one of those things. The Lancers. Yeah, those are pretty popular. I love the idea of a spear using, class, but, you know, it like I said, it's pretty popular, so everyone kind of plays. Well, I mean, you see them all over the place. And it's pretty easy to see why they're popular. They're pretty badass looking. But, decided to not do that. Like I said, I wanted to do something a little different than I usually do. And having played the, I'm just like scrolling through this shit real fast for you, aren't I? Sorry about that. But anyway, I don't even know what this guy was saying. Alright, but he does have our next quest, so we're gonna go ahead and pick that up. You may be hearing some shit in the background. That would be because it's like raining and stuff, and it's like a thunderstorm and shit outside, so. Yeah, there's a little bit of thunder now. But anyway, we have to go get this dude's shit that he dropped because he got scared when he went into a cave or whatever. With all the meaningless tasks we do, I'm okay with it, though. Kind of, like I said, this game really gives you like a lot of just introductory kind of normal bullshit for a while. I think really level 15 is when things kind of start actually taking shape and you get some some sort of real, you know, storyline. But, these little weird-ass things. These big-ass salamanders are cool as shit, though. Fuck, I like those things. But anyhow, we're just gonna throw rocks at this fucker. I think, like, I do find that kind of entertaining, the fact that we just throw rocks and shit. But anyhow, once we do get Arcanist, kind of going back to that, it's gonna be, like I said, it'll liven our class up a little bit. We'll have a few extra spells and stuff. I think I'm gonna go do that on my own time and just level that up, because you only need it leveled up to 15, and it's pretty easy to get that far, in all honesty. Especially if we're already gonna have casting gear, and probably at that time, no, take that back, I know at that time, we are going to, or I am going to invest in, whatever you wouldn't call it, the, I will invest in the trade skills, some of the trade skills, and stuff. I need to do a little research to see what we need to pick up here in Gridania before we move on to that. Because when you go to Uldan, or Ulda, I think it's just Ulda, but maybe it is Uldan, I don't know. It's been a long time since I've been in that part of the world, because I started there with my first character and I just didn't like it. But anyway, when we get there, I'm gonna pick up the, whatever the hell it's called, the spinner or whatever, the, basically to make cloth armor and shit for ourselves. And I don't know what, I have no idea what supplementary or gathering professions it needs. So like I said, I'll go do some research on that, try and figure that out so we can, you know, hopefully wear something other than these god-awful yellow mittens that we have on. Like, this isn't too bad. And I've said this before, I think, but I am kind of surprised that this game, oh no, I don't want the water sprite. I am kind of surprised that this game doesn't have a, whatever you want to call it, like a cosmetic system. I think they do, I don't, just don't think I've unlocked it yet. But anyway, and, yeah, I'll shut up. There's a lot that happens at around like level 15 to 20. I mean, you get your mounts at 20, you get the retainers somewhere around in there, like 17 or something like that. Something like that. But you get a lot of stuff. Like I said, that's when I feel like the, you know, the am I missing something in here? That's when I feel like the, no, they're there. That's when I feel like the storyline kind of picks up and is actually, gets interesting, because then you start doing some neat little cutscenes and you have some things to do and all that good shit. And like I said, you start, you know, going to the other regions and you explore some shit and all that good stuff. So, like I said, it'll get better. We won't have just these two spells forever. I know that's kind of boring and it is kind of blah, and that is one thing I don't really care for about this game too much. How restricted the classes are. I mean, once again, your armor and all that stuff, you're pretty much just shoehorned into whatever the white mage is supposed to have. A stick. I did not know we had these little wands and a little tiny little shield, but I mean, generally, you're just kind of given just the stock equipment, and that's pretty much it. But you know, and if you know anything about me, you know I like a lot of stuff that's a little bit more open-ended that you get when you get more. Let's see, can we go? Actually, that might be the best way to go. Yeah, I like it when it's a little more open-ended and I have a little more freedom to dress how I want or wear what I want and at least have the weapon that I want. You know, I don't mind being restricted to, like, you know, two-handed weapons as a warrior or whatever, but I want to at least use something other than just a two-handed axe. Because I like hammers. What can I say? I like hammers. Which, that is one thing I wish. The Dark Knight was not a class that you unlock at level 50 or whatever. That is one thing that kind of irks me a bit, because I like the idea of the Dark Knight a lot. I mean, I just really do. I like that sort of thing, and that would be something that I would be playing right now if they let you pick those fuckers up at level 1, but Unfortunately, you cannot. So we're stuck with this until we get up there, and then it's open to us. So, of course, you have to do, once again, certain quests to have it open to you as well. So that gets kind of annoying sometimes. I mean, they are very quest-heavy, quest-centric in this game. I mean, everything you do is basically based on that. And if certain things aren't open up to you in the game, it's because you haven't done the quest. But, anyhow. So, I don't know if you've noticed, but we're kind of being given like a little tour of the zone and kind of giving you like a tour of how questing and stuff is supposed to work. You do a few over here, you move on, you do a few over there. That sort of thing. That's ideally what they're doing here, and you, I believe, need to go back and do some quests like in earlier parts of this zone to open up shit like here, like these two. I don't know specifically, but usually it's something like that, and they tell you to go to whatever this place is, some guy's tower or whatever. They tell you to go here, and then, you know, then the quests when you get here are open to you. So we'll go with the... I can't wear that yet. Bollocks. Hey, look at that. Now I fucking can. Oh, we got Protect. That's neat. We have Protect. We have Protect, and we can wear new panties now. We have new panties on. Yes. 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 Okay. Yeah, now we have some quests open over here as well. I'm going to put you there. So I believe, yeah, you're a 30-minute buff, yeah. Just your typical buffage, nothing all that, I don't know what you want to call it, exciting or abstract. So I have to go kill some pigs. Slay hoglets, slay the hoglets. We must go and slay all the things. Alright, I'm going to kill these microchews while we're here. I did see the water sprites earlier, but I was like, fuck it, I'm too lazy. Didn't want to do it, so now we will, since the microchews are literally right here. Me, I don't believe I have to go too far for these stupid pigs, do we? I do like the little shield thing when they hit you, when you got Protect on. That's fucking neat. I think that's fucking neat. Alright, fuck these microchews. Although I do think these microchews are cute. I think they're fucking adorable. They really are. And just look at these little guys. Mini chews. Brings back fucking memories of FF10 when you're like fighting that one and kill a ton of shit. Yep. Good times. Good times. Boom. Hit my rocks. Hit my rocks. Eat my rocks, bitch. Eat my rocks. So, alright, where in the fuck do we have to go? Let's figure this out. Oh, I'm going the wrong goddamn way. I'm going the wrong way to kill pigs. Go figure. But anyway, we'll go, yeah, it's this way. Down here into the hole. Into the hole. The environment in this game is really cool, I think. I have to admit, I think it's really neat. I do enjoy just kind of wandering around in this game and seeing things. I don't really care about the fate. Alright. Ooh, hello, Hoglet. You're a big-ass pig. You look like those pig fuckers in FF12. That's what you look like. Whatever they're called. I don't remember. I don't remember what their race was called. They got like, whoa, fuck that. I'm not hanging out in that. Mm-mm. Whatever that was, that didn't look friendly. Fuck you. Jesus, we gotta slay six of these damn things. They do kind of look like them, don't they? Hold my DOT, bitch. Like I said, I wish I had more of them. I like DOTs a lot. And I think it's something that would be unofficial to a healer to have some DOTs. I mean, we don't have to be like some giant ass, you know, big ass spell slinging monster. Jesus, level 8s. Good God. Now, I'm not gonna lie to you, with Protect, I will forget that it's there and that it like goes down or whatever, you know what I mean? I mean, just saying, I'm gonna forget that shit, so if you, you know, are screaming at the screen, just remember that I can't hear you. And I do that shit a lot. A lot. Like, I seriously will get on and, like, put my buff on once and then never see it again. Mm-hmm. Or never see it again, never use it again. Like, I'll just not really expect that the, I won't necessarily expect that the buff stays on the whole time while I'm playing, but I just don't think about it. I mean, there's been times where I'll fucking play and I'll be on for like 2 hours and never even buff myself. It's just the way I do it. I think a lot of it is being lazy and having played games where, you know, you put on a buff and it's pretty much on all the time. Kind of like this cleric stance thing. Yeah, I mean, it's one of those things like that where you just, I'm used to those little things that you just toggle on and off, and when you have something that has a timer on it, I just fucking forget. See, that's where I would really like to have like an extra DOT so I can just pop it on them, like something short term so I can pop it on them when I'm dodging shit. Instead of having to like cancel my cast. That's one thing that kept me right here. Right here, right now. Ah, fuck you. I do think. Oh boy, you're way over level for that thing. You're destroying that shit. Here, let's get a little experience for it. Oh, alright, they're just gonna fucking beat me to everything because I'm a slow ass caster. Tag that one, bitch. That's right, fucker. Cute hair though. Anyhow, that's also one of the reasons why I don't really like MMOs a lot sometimes, especially certain MMOs. I mean, I hate tagging. I think that's stupid. I mean, when you have a PvE environment, I mean, fuck, okay, there we go, that's all my hogs. When you have a PvE environment and then you make it a competition to kill things for a quest, that's a little counterproductive in my mind. I mean, if you want people to play against the environment together and encounter certain and attack certain monsters, especially if you put, like mini world bosses and shit like that, like big tough monsters that give you lots of reward for killing them, and yet it's not an open tapping system where anyone who's walking by can just jump in and help that person kill it. I mean, quite often, and I've done this a million times in MMOs, I mean, someone's doing something like that, killing some tough monster, I just walk right by, I don't fucking care. I mean, I could care less, seriously. I mean, it's just, fuck you. Go ahead and die. Because I know you wouldn't help me when I was killing that thing. Just saying. But anyhow, that's just me, and I'm a dickhead. I'm not going to lie. Alright, I'll take those, I guess. Alright. Getting all sorts of shit done today. Goddamn. Oh, we got a level 9 one. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. We have to go kill some anoles. Alright, then. Anoles are cute, by the way. I wouldn't want to kill one. Cute little lizards. Anyhow, apparently they're growing angry and stuff, and we have to go take their eggs. How fucked up is that? We gotta take their eggs. We gotta take their eggs and kill them. Ugh. Such terrible people we are. Such terrible people we are. Alright, I want these. Put those on. Put that shit on. Can I get something other than these big ass mittens? That'd be nice. Alright. Alright, let's go kill some anoles. Because we are supposed to. Microchews! It's so cute, microchew! Alright, microchew. Where are these guys. These are the anoles that they're speaking of. These things are weird. They're weird looking. They're like little, they're like some raptor looking things. With little baby wings on their back. And no front paws. It's so weird. I don't like them. They look like something you should be riding, not something you should be killing. These things look like they should be like the first mount you have instead of a chocobo. You know what I mean? It's just bullshit. I don't like them. Jesus, we cast really slow sometimes. At first it seems that way to me. Good lord. A blood. Alright. And let's heal ourselves. Because damn, we got the heals. Alright, these two are just going to chew through this shit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be sneaky and I'm going to attack the ones that they're not going after. Oops, that's not what I want. But I do want to hit him with arrow and then rocks on your face. Because I can. Oh, fuck that. Fuck that. I don't know what it's going to do. I do like how, I think I mentioned this before, I do like how they, like, do the little ground thing. They give you some time, at least, to get out of the way, and it's like, oh, shit. And it's really easy to avoid stuff, too. It's, I mean, you don't have to go running, you know, 30 feet to get out of the fucking blast area. That's something I really appreciate in this game. Please tell me their eggs aren't something on the ground that I gotta pick up. That's gonna really suck ass. I'm not really gonna be happy about that if I gotta go hunt this shit with these other people walking around doing this as well, because that's just not very fun at all. Should be able to cast on the move, by the way, just saying. Yeah, fuck you, slay you dumbass. Alright, we need anole eggs. Motherfucker. They are over here. God damn it all. We could very well die here. Although, I don't know. I mean, we might be able to tough it out. Not get too wrecked by these guys. They're not really doing too much damage to us. Although they are making this annoying as hell, and really takes a while to kill them. I am gonna do that. So, oh yeah, you get that spirit bond with stuff. I don't remember what that shit does, but it does something. It does something. See, these fuckers right here. Oh. Daddy finds an egg. That's right, fucker. Give me an egg. Got your eggs. Get your kids. Yes, please, go ahead and kill all them. Go ahead, do all that, because I'm going to just sneak right up in here and be like, yoink. Thank you. Keep up the good work, peeps, while I steal your eggs. Because I only need two more. We can get those two more on the way out. On the way out. See a motherfucker. Oh, shit. That was frightening. Ran right into the thing. Alright, I am gonna just dump off right here. And here we are. Quest done and completed. Pretty much. As long as we don't get attacked in the ass by one of these weird things. They're just weird. Like I said, they look so harmless too. I think that's the thing that freaks me out about it. Like, you look at them, they're like, you know, it's like fighting a deer. You know, like, when has a deer or a buck, you know, ever looked fucking, I mean, I don't know about you, but, you know, there's never been a time in my life where I was like, that damn buck is gonna fuck my shit up. No, never been like that. Never pulled a stone cold and went, you know, stunner on a fucking buck before out of fear for my life. But, I mean, I'm just saying. It's just, I don't know. It weirds me out. It doesn't, like a bunny. Like, bunnies aren't threatening. Of course, that is the whole draw of, you know, Monty Python, but yeah, it is what it is. It's just not threatening. It's not anything threatening that I feel like I need to defend myself from. Right? I mean, right? Anyhow, report to Pauline. Oh, she's got some more shit for us to take us back to Jedi Thick. Green deer, bent branch. There we go. Those are the words I'm looking for. Put in Gabino's tower. That guy, he's just hanging out. Are you ever turning? You have returned. We got eggs. I'm pleased to see you. That's great. Deliver the eggs to Sublime Kamazaman at the Bannock. Which I'm going the wrong motherfucking way. because I got all turned around and shit over here. So we are going to go and head back that way. What's up, guys? Just hanging out. Should I do this? Should I do the water sprites? Should I do it? Yeah, we're just going to do it, because it's usually like three. That's the only reason why I'm going to do these, you know, while we're playing. It's because they're only like three. We ain't got to kill very many of these damn things. I think the most it's ever been is like five or seven. Or that I've seen anyway. I mean, it's just one of those things where it's not very much. So it's quick and easy. I mean, it even tells you right here, you know, one of three. It only takes three to kill these. And get the extra little experience thing. So, I mean, ooh, it's throwing water at me. Take that. Why is my arrow not killing you? Yeah, we do have a really weak, what do you want to call it? A really weak, ooh, maybe I can get two of those things. I don't want two of them. I only want one. Okay, alright, the other one's going the other way. We do have a really, like, our DOT is really weak, but it is a debuffer, I believe. I think. Am I losing my shit? Yeah, I'm losing my shit. It doesn't do anything other than debuff them, so. Haha, motherfucker, we just leveled up! What? You know, that's right. Alright, so we're here. We're gonna turn this shit in. And I think we're gonna call it a day. Because, oh, he's got more shit for us here. More shit. Another delivery? Yeah, eggs for you to eat. I guess, because, yeah, they're eating them. Alright, so put that ring, because that ring is awesome. And it's for us. Rabble. Alright, what in the hell was I? Okay, that's what I want. That's what I want right there. Holy shit, we haven't put either of these on? Equip you and equip you. A nano adder ring in there. Alright, so we'll go ahead and pick this quest up from Gottfried. Tell me what I need to know. Why are you giving me a longbow? And a spear. And a stick. Oh, I have to train people? Oh. Now we gotta go kill some more stuff. Alright. Anyhow, we have to slay some Efts, which are basically just those big ass salamanders that we saw when we were walking by. But anyhow, that does it for this episode. If you made it this far on YouTube, you know what to do. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye.